Show me your habits and I'll show you your future. Day by day, what you do is who you become. And in order to become who you want to be, you need to have a system in place for adopting and sticking to new habits. And this video will show you how to build that system. If you want to grab this habit tracker for yourself, then feel free to do so through the first link in the description. Now, without further ado, let's get started. Before we build anything, let me first show you how it works. When you're starting with a new day, you can click on the Notion button and you'll see a new database entry being created. You can also use the buttons underneath to check off each of your habits. This database has a template button that will load a quick morning and evening bullet journal, and it also contains three different views. A gallery view showing today's habits, a weekly calendar view, and a table view grouped by the week. And then lastly, at the bottom of the page, you have a line graph that will update and show the progress of your habits throughout the month. So let's now actually create the habit tracker. We're first going to create the database, then add the Notion buttons, and then add our line graph. So let's start off by creating a new table view database. Let's give our database a name and then hide the title. The first properties we're going to add is a date property and a created time property. And then we're going to add a checkbox property for each of our habits and also change the property icon for each of them. And then lastly, we want to add two formula properties, which will be for the progress bar and the progress ring. Inside the progress ring formula, you want to use the toNumber function, then select one of your habits, add a closing bracket, and then add a plus and repeat this step until you've added all of your habits. Then inside the formula property, you want to select the progress ring, change the number to the amount of habits you have, and then also change the color. And now for the progress bar. For this formula, we're going to start off with a round function to get rid of any decimals. And then inside of the round function, we want to add 100 multiplied by, and then inside of brackets, we're going to add our habits. To do this, we're going to use the unary plus function. Type in unary plus, click on the function, then click inside of the bracket, select one of your habits, and then close the bracket. Then you just want to add a plus and then repeat this step until all of your habits are added. Once all of your habits are added, you want to add another closing bracket and then divide everything by the total number of habits. And then lastly, you want to add another closing bracket to close off the round function and then just divide everything by 100. Then for the property, you want to make sure that the number format is percent and that you have the progress bar selected. And now every time you add a new habit, all you have to do is just add it to both of the formulas, like we just did, and then just update the total number of habits for the progress ring and inside the formula for the progress bar. Now let's finish setting up our database by adding our three views. The first view is a gallery view with the card preview set to none and the card size set to small. Then we're going to go into the properties tab and show all of our habits as well as our progress bar. You can also drag your habits around depending on the order you complete them throughout the day. And now the last thing for this view is to filter the date property to today and then create an advanced filter where you want to choose the OR option and then filter the created time property also to today. And then simply just rename the view and add an icon. Now for the second view, it's going to be a calendar, but inside the layout tab, you want to turn it into a weekly calendar. And then for this view, we're also just going to show the exact same properties as the previous view. And if you want, you can also change the icon to one of Notion's native calendar icons. And the last view is going to be the table view. Inside the layout tab, make sure the vertical lines are turned off. And then for the properties tab, you only want to show the name, date, progress ring, and your habits. For the progress ring, you want to collapse it to make it smaller and then move it all the way to the left. Once the properties are done, we're going to group this view according to the date property and then select the weekly option, showing the newest entries first and hiding all of the empty groups. And the last thing we're going to do is click calculate at the bottom of each habit and select percent checked. We're also going to calculate the week's progress by clicking on the number next to a group, going to the average tab and then selecting the progress ring or progress bar. You can also of course group your habits to the month if you wish to track your monthly progress instead of your weekly progress. And then lastly, just rename the view to weekly and add an icon. Now that our database is set up, we're going to create a recurring template button and then add our buttons and line graph. To create a template button, click on the drop down next to new and then click on new template button. Give your template button an icon and a name. I would recommend using add today as the name. And then inside of the template button, you can create your own bullet journal, or you can just pause the video and use the one on the screen. All of these are just call out boxes set to the default color with the text in bold and underlined. Once your template pattern is finished, you want to click on the menu and set the template pattern as default. Now to set up a recurring template pattern, simply click on the template pattern menu, click on the repeat and select the daily option. Select the start date as well as the time it should create a new database entry and then click save. Now if you're going to use the recurring template pattern instead of manually adding database entries, you'll have to group your calendar and table database views to the created time property instead of the date property, because now you won't be using the normal date anymore. Now let's set up our Notion buttons. If you're not going to use the recurring template button, you can create a button that will automatically add a new database entry. Simply create a new button and select the Add Pages option. Select your Habit Tracker database, add today as the name, and also add today for the date property. You can also add another step that will instantly open up the newly created page as a center view, so you can quickly fill out the morning section of the bullet journal. And then lastly, just make sure to add a name and an icon for your button. Now for the buttons that's going to check off your habits. Create a new button and select the Edit Pages option and then select your database. Filter the button to only edit the pages with today's date. Choose your habit checkbox property and select check. Give your button a name if you want, or just leave it empty and add an icon. Then simply duplicate the button and change the habit and icon, drag it next to your other button, and then just repeat this for every single one of your habits. If you want to learn more about the new Notion buttons, then just check out my previous video showing you 9 different ways to use the new Notion buttons through the link in the description. Now this last section is all about setting up a line graph to visualize the progress of your habits throughout the month. For this, we're going to be using Notion to Charts. Go ahead and sign up to create a new account and then connect it to Notion. For this, you want to go to your settings, connect your Notion account, select which pages you want to give access to, and then click Allow Access. Once Notion is connected, you can go ahead and create a new chart. You'll see there's a bunch of options, but for this, we're going to use the line chart. Go ahead and select your Habit Tracker database, and then for the x-axis, you want to select the created time or date property, depending on if you're using recurring template patterns or not, and the y-axis is going to be your progress bar. When you go ahead and create your chart, you'll see you have a bunch of customization options. You can change or hide the graph name, you can change the color when you go to the single color tab, and you can choose whether or not you want to group your graph to the day, week, month, quarter, or year. For this graph, I'd recommend choosing the day option, at least for the beginning, and then when you feel like there's too much database entries, you can change it to the weekly or monthly options. You also want to make sure that you're sorting the graph according to the created time or date property and that it is ascending. When you're done with the graph, all that's left is just to grab the link at the top right and then go inside of Notion, paste the link and then click on Create Embed. Then simply just resize the graph and turn on dark mode. And there you go, a habit tracker that uses the new Notion buttons and Notion charts to visualize your progress. Feel free to grab this template through the first link in the description and make sure to watch this next video showing you how to upgrade the aesthetics of your Notion dashboard.